dance parties is another way of expanding your business, isn't it, Dawn?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, not only expanding your business underneath your dance school name, but you could even set up like another sister company. It's a whole business in itself.
Yeah, you could be offering children's parties, children's dance parties, hen parties, and even venture into the corporate world and do corporate dance parties.
Yeah.
So some of you sitting there now thinking, well, how do you go about doing this? I mean, how much are you going to charge? There must be lots of questions going around in your head. Well, if we start from the beginning and work backwards, maybe we'll get to answer some of your questions.
Mm.
So the first thing is about charging. Well, you can't just say, I'm going to charge X, Y, Z until you've worked out your costings and worked out what you are worth time-wise.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, things need to be customizable according to what the customer wants, okay? So, for instance, if you have a child and the mum, parent, wants you to hold a dance party, what is it they're expecting you to do? How long are they expecting you to be there? Are they expecting you to also organise the DJ, you know, the food? We don't recommend you organise the food, but maybe you want to include that within the actual package. And outsource it, like find caterers to also work with you to just put on the party, and really compare your prices with other children parties out there, like football parties and things like that.
Another thing to consider, when you mentioned football parties, they are often done maybe in someone's garden, or you might travel to where they always practice football in a club. With the dance party, I mean, you could be going to someone's house, or they could be coming to your dance studio. So all of those are going to be costs that you're going to reflect in your pricing. Obviously, if it's you travelling to their venue, then you're going to include the cost of petrol as well. The other thing is when we've done parties before, when we did children's parties, we used to provide little party bags, goodie bags, and do little mini makeovers. They're great. Kids love that, especially if it's like a themed idea. Example,
you might
do something like, I don't know, High School Musical or something. The only thing I want to stress is, if you're going to be including like mini makeovers and putting makeup on children, just bits of glitter or, you know, whatever, coloured hairspray, you need to get consent from parents beforehand, just to avoid the problems of allergies and that kind of thing.
Yeah, I mean, so you want to find out what content do they actually want in the dance party, or maybe not necessarily find out, but you're to come up with the idea to tell them what you can do for the dance party, okay? So are you going to be choreographing a little mini birthday routine for the parents to see when they come back at the end? Or are you going to do that as well as like do like a competition maybe? Are you going to be providing the props? As Suzanne said, makeup is one. And what about all the other props which could be needed? Maybe you're going to be providing costumes for them to wear and stuff like that.
So depending on what you're providing and the structure of your dance party, it can last between 2 hours, 3 hours, 90 minutes.
Yeah.
This is an unknown quantity. Again, you're going to have to work that out. I mean, some people that offer dance parties, they will include the cost of that break, you know, in between you teaching the routine and showing it. And that break might be the time when they have the party food. So, you know, it's your time. Are you going to charge that, or are you going to say, don't worry, I'm going to get a bit of the birthday cake?
Yeah. I mean, with regards to going into the corporate sector now, you want to look at, for instance, are you going to be doing a dance party because the corporation or the corporate company want their staff to experience this as some kind of a skill? So we're looking at experiential learning here. So is it a case where they're looking to use dance as a way or a method to improve their staff skills, maybe leadership skills, maybe teamwork skills, or whatever it's going to be, which has them come out of a complete comfort zone, but to use it as a way so that their staff are more connected maybe. If you are in a troupe or a group, then that's something else you can also bring to the table with regard to corporate parties and putting on demonstrations and presentations.
So think about the age again of your guests that you're providing this party for, and think, you know, what would they enjoy dancing to? You know, if you're going to do a corporate party, you know, depending on the age of the company, what sort of employees they've got there, you want to consider what kind of lyrics will be in the music. I think that's more important than doing children's parties, actually. Make sure it's clean.
What dance games can you build into doing dance parties, especially for corporate companies. You want to look at that if that is what they're looking, and definitely charge a lot more when it comes to corporate companies.
And do your diligence, because if this party's going to be outside, like in a marquee style party on the grass, can I actually do that routine on grass? Will you have an extension cable long enough to actually put your CD player on, whatever it is you're using?
Yeah.
So you need to think about that, and also, will you need an assistant? Because if it is a corporate party, say for example, for loads and loads of employees there, you're going to need someone else who's going to be helping you with the routines, especially if you're doing something that involves couple, routine, man, lady, that kind of thing. So do your due diligence, work out all your costumes first, think about what is it the client wants from the party before wrapping it up in the package.
Yeah, and don't forget to have your contracts in place. So everyone signs everything, and also show them your insurance certificates and any CRB checks as well if you're working with children in the UK, that is.